Throughout our whole series on climate change, we have covered different aspects of the issue, from the science behind climate change to how it's causing extreme weather. You might think that this is all we can cover, but now, as we all have a good grasp on the problem, it's important to recognize the other possible consequences and what we can do to help based on our current situation.
In today's episode of Gearing Up to Climate Change series, we will uncover the consequences of climate change through examining data, as well as discover how we, both as individuals and as a part of a community, can make a positive difference in the fight against climate change. So the consequences of climate change are very broad, but the most well-known is undoubtedly the rising temperature, or as we usually call it, global warming. According to the NOAA's temperature data, 2020 was the second warmest year ever recorded, and the temperatures are only expected to continue rising. The Earth's temperature has increased at an average rate of 0.13 degrees Fahrenheit per decade since 1880. However, the current average rate has doubled since 1981.
Global warming causes many of the problems we face today, including rising sea levels and extreme temperatures and more. If we continue to neglect global warming, the risks of these natural disasters will increase, which can lead to serious impacts to humans and the ecosystem through damaging agricultural lands, city infrastructures, causing health issues, and more. To learn more about extreme weather and its connection to climate change, please watch the third episode in the series if you haven't already.
Another issue caused by climate change is the rising sea levels. This occurs when glaciers melt due to increased temperatures and thermal expansion related to global warming. Our sea levels currently rise at a rate of 3.175 millimeters per year. Now, this may not seem like a concern due to how small the number is, but the consequences can be deadly to small islands and coastal cities, as well as animals who depend on the glaciers like polar bears.
A country that is experiencing serious impacts from rising sea levels is Tuvalu, where the nation is not only facing the threat of having 2 of 9 islands being swallowed by rising sea levels and coastal erosion, but also their collapsing economy. Inhabitants of the nation are heavily impacted by the contamination of underground water caused by rising sea levels, along with their main source of food, fish, being impacted by Ciguatera poisoning, caused by bleached corals, which is caused by ocean acidification, which we will go more in depth on later. Tuvalu has also been experiencing more frequent and intense storm surges, along with decreasing levels of rainfall, which is detrimental to their agriculture.
With all these damages combined, the people of Tuvalu are losing their homeland and are forced to rely on foreign aid. This example perfectly demonstrates damages and consequences of climate change, as well as the result if we choose not to address this climate crisis. As we mentioned previously, bleached corals are poisoning fish due to ocean acidification. But what is it, and why is it happening? Ocean acidification is also a consequence of climate change. Did you know that 30% of the CO2 released into the Earth's atmosphere is absorbed into the ocean? As more CO2 is being emitted by humans, the amount absorbed by the ocean also increases. As CO2 is being dissolved into the ocean, it forms carbonic acid, and this in turn makes the ocean's average pH level more acidic. This change is currently affecting many species, including coral. Due to the acidification, corals may not be able to maintain their structure and might even dissolve.
This change also affects some species' ability to develop, detect predators, and find suitable habitats. An example of this would be Dungeness crabs. In a recent study, it was found that ocean acidification is impacting their shells and sensory organs. Species that reside in water and have exoskeletons rely on calcium carbonate for their structure. However, due to ocean acidification, carbonate ions are scarce, making it difficult for them to maintain their exoskeletons. The damages ocean acidification create are detrimental to the fishing industry as well as ecosystems.
For humans, climate change raises potential health risks as well as economic damages as it increases the likelihood of extreme weather, rising sea levels, and much more. An extended wildfire season will expose the residents in the area to smoke, which leads to irritation, illness of the respiratory system, damages to the forest ecosystem and the forest industry, as well as an increase in the rate of homelessness.
Another scary and shocking example are the deadly floods in the central province of China, Henan, that was impacted by climate change. This crisis resulted in direct economic losses of 2.25 billion yuan, or roughly $348 million USD, along with damages in agricultural products and city infrastructures.
Although it is not an easy task for us humans to reverse climate change and the damages we have caused, STEM professionals are working on innovations that can help resolve the climate crisis and help us change the world for the better.
The STEM field has always been related to climate change because of the contributions that engineers and scientists have made in reducing the damages that climate change has caused.
As we discussed in a previous video on the benefits of electric vehicles, engineers are working hard on improving the battery production process as well as making many other technological advancements. This will ensure that the emissions of electric vehicles will continue to be reduced, and this will further assist us in reducing our carbon footprint.
STEM education will also contribute to resolving climate change by raising awareness of this crisis to future generations, which goes back to the whole reason why we decided to make this series.
STEM professionals aren't the only ones that can make a difference. Individual efforts matter a lot as well. And this means that your actions can make a difference. So now you might be wondering, what should I do? Well, we touched upon this in a previous video, but there is so much more. You can try to use alternative modes of transportation for short trips and commutes, such as riding a bike, running, or using public transportation. These methods still get you to your destination while also helping out the environment.
You can also practice energy-saving methods, such as turning off electronics in your house while going outside, using sustainable and renewable resources, as well as practicing recycling. You can also consume less dairy and meat products or switch to a plant-based diet altogether, as meat and animal agriculture significantly contributes to the climate change through greenhouse gas emissions.
We can also get our voices heard by policymakers to help in the fight against climate change by advocating for more bike lanes, a better public transit system, and much more. You can also donate to a nonprofit organization if you were able to. And we can gather more people to make our voice stronger and more impactful.
With all these efforts, we can help to combat climate change. Thank you for checking out our video.
If you like what you saw, please like, share, and subscribe for more. And if you want to learn more, or just learn what you can do, be sure to click the links in the description below.
Stay tuned for our next episode.